You rejected me. You listened to the devil. You showed him confidence. You who until yesterday knew nothing of Satan, you so easily made him your trusted friend and master. I respected your freedom, although you owe it to me. You surrendered it to your fiercest enemy. You unwittingly became his aider and abettor, and you have paid for it with your misfortune. Above all, you failed to understand that your enemy used you to root their eternal evil in your kingdom, in the place where I put you, heaven, so you could never, never find peace again.
And the children from St. Anne's Orphanage. David's favorite toy. It even resembles him.
Tragedy strikes again. It was only a few days ago that another boy was reported missing from St. Mary's Church. This is the seventh in a string of children reported missing since just last month. All of them were poor souls from St. Anne's Orphanage, apparently under the custody of Father Abraham Marcus. Eyewitness confirms...
They've gone mad. Are they accusing me? Each night I pray for the safe return of the altar boy. God is my witness. Could there be an unholy will at work here?
Now, we have breaking news about the killer priest from Black Tower. Eyewitness confirms he really did murder those eight children. Father Ryan Carpenter is here with a message for him.
Father, we have to speak about what you did. You used to call them angels, but in the end you killed them with a straight razor. They were innocent children, Father. There's blood on your hands. There's even blood on the altar. You're a demented maniac. Satan has prepared a place by his side just for you. He plans to make you commander of his army of demons. Congratulations!
Heavenly Father, help me in these dark times, for you know I am your humble servant. I hear the demons gnawing at my faith. My mind is clouded by doubt. Guide me towards the light in these darkest of hours. Wherever the child may be, I know you are with him. I will not lose my faith. I know you will give me a sign.
Forgive me, Father. Tonight I will leave this world. My suffering is more than I can bear. I always thought I could find solace among the mortals, but I was a fool. You'll find me at the end of the world. I am waiting for you, and please, do not despair.
Could this mean that you're alive? David, can you ever forgive me? Indispensable addiction. This place? Is this another of the devil's tricks?
This place is not of your world. It is within the grasp of heaven. It is a part of paradise. God himself gave us this place. Only the brave, the righteous, and the loving can stay here. You're not one of them yet. In time, you'll change. Soon your eyes will see the truth. You'll break the seal of the mystery.
Of Christ. What a curious gift.
You will find more of these. They are all scattered around my world. Bring 8 of them to the great priest, and he will reveal a great mystery to you about life and death. Remember, every place that you'll visit in my world has a hidden icon somewhere. Leave no stone unturned.
Was that place even real? I think I'm going insane.
We've invited our beloved Father Ryan Carpenter to talk about the recent events. Good evening, Father, and Merry Christmas.
Good evening, and thank you for the invitation. May God bless us all. Regarding these events, I think we are paying for the sins we've actually never committed.
So you are saying we are being punished for someone else's sins? Are you talking about Father Abraham?
Listen, my son. I always carry a Bible by my side. Remember the 9th commandment? Thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor.
How vile.
But in this case, how can I not speak of him?
So, is Father Abraham involved?
Obviously, we are dealing with a monster. Fear the beast, for it has been unchained and is walking our very streets. This
This is the sign that the world is coming to an end. The return of our Lord Jesus Christ is ahead. Be afraid. Be very afraid. The beast could be in your very homes at this instant, and you won't even know it.
Very grim warning indeed. Now, Father, I'm a simple man. I'm not a very religious person, and I do not believe everything that is written in the Bible. Are you implying that Father Abraham is a beast? A priest?
Of course.
But how could this be possible?
Listen. Firstly, you invited me here on your show in the middle of the night, when I could have been at church and praying for some pitiful soul. Secondly, you haven't read the Bible, so you shouldn't speak about things you do not know. Those matters are difficult to comprehend. Such a simple mind as yours could never understand. Those are dangerous things. Lastly, I have a question for you. Who exactly do you think you are?
I'm Judas Griffin.
Exactly. You remind me of how Judas the Iscariot betrayed Jesus for a fistful of coins. That's exactly what you intend to do with me. Everything about your so-called midnight show is about money.
I want the blood and the flesh of Christ.
The blood and the flesh of Christ. But that means red wine and sacramental bread. The blood and the flesh of Christ. But that means red wine and sacramental bread.
Ratings. Remember how Judas died?
There's something strange about those eyes. I don't like them staring at that door.
God, the creator of all things, is no more. God is dead. The creator of all things is no more. God is dead. The creator of all things is no more. God is dead.
sacramental bread. What kind of trick is this? Who brought these mannequins here from the basement? Holy water.
There is a story about a priest and his whore. His name was Father Abraham, and her name was Lady Alexandra. It is said that she was a faithful creature, visiting the church often at night to confess her sins. Of course, Father Abraham would ask God for forgiveness. Later in the night, they would speak again about sins. This time, it would be on how to commit them. She would touch him. Her carnal lust knew no shame. She would plead with him to touch her sinful flesh and to feel the sweetness of her lips. Once she told him, "I want to feel the taste of the cross on my lips. I want to be part of your madness, to make liturgy of sins, to drink the blood of Christ and to eat his flesh, to bathe in his blood, to be one with him. This is blasphemy!" There is a story about a priest and his whore. His name was Father Abraham, and her name was Lady Alexandra. It is said that she was a faithful...
I never felt ashamed about my relationship with Alexandra. She always had a peculiar passion about the church and about me, especially me. I'm not going any further. There's something down there, or someone. The Roman ritual. I used this on David to banish the demon that tormented us for a long time. the smell of wine.
From the tree with a rope of a dead mule.
I apologize for angering you, Father. We have just a few seconds left. Do you have anything to say to our audience to calm the spirits?
Stop searching for your missing children unless you're truly prepared. Say... What is this? Thank you.
David, if you don't show yourself, the entire village will see me off to the gallows.
Grown-ups never understand anything by themselves, and it is tiresome for children to be always and forever explaining things to them. Listen, I want to give my mother a flower, but the flower is dead. Can you bring it to life?